This is our introduction to Audacity. You can see I have an icon for it right on the desktop. But before we go into Audacity and learn how to record our voices into our computers, we need to set the microphone boost. And when I first plugged in my microphone and tried to record something, here a couple of weeks ago, I wasn't getting any sound. There was sound there because I could see the little dials moving. I could tell it was hearing me, but the sound waves, it was just a straight line, so I knew there was no volume. What I first did was I knew I had back in my closet a hardware microphone amplifier. And I plugged that in, and of course that did the trick. But then I remembered, it's only been a year, but I remembered that there was a software booster for the microphone. And that's all you need, because it really works well. So, to find that, you are going to look for the audio icon on my computer setup. It's at the top here. But for you, it might be on the bottom, depending upon which version of Musix you are using. So you click on that. That's usually just where you set your volume. And you click on Mixer. Okay. Now, when we first go into the mixer, it doesn't include any of the microphones in the initial settings. Okay. But we're going to add it. So we come up here to Settings, Configure Channels. And we're going to find, microphone and mic boost. Now, you might want to include stereo mic. I'm going to put mic and just drag it over here. Okay, now it's giving me a little funny symbol, like it doesn't want to do that. Okay, let me do mic boost. That is the important one. There we go. Oh, there we go. Okay. Okay, so I have the stereo mic and the mic boost listed over here in the visible channels. Click OK. And see, that way I can make sure that the settings that your microphone is not muted and also that mic boost is not muted. Okay. Because you're going to need that for Audacity. So I'm going to close it. And now let's go into Audacity. Just click on it. And click OK. And one thing, I've actually started this lesson like 3, 4, or 5 times because I've encountered things that I needed to adjust. And one thing I discovered is the Record My Desktop program, you know, which lets me have my voice and I can go and open windows and point at things. That program conflicts with Audacity because they are both audio recording programs and the computer can only do one of them at once. So I cannot record something right this moment. So I recorded something earlier. I can do that. So I'm going to come over here to File and Import Audio and come back and find my file. And let's see. There we go. Audacity Lesson 1 Demo. That's it. Okay. Okay, so this is what Audacity looks like. This is after you have recorded something. Audacity is really a very, very, very simple program to use. There are a couple of things that can trip you up. Well, one of them is, if you don't have the mic boost on, and depending upon your particular system, maybe your microphone comes with an amplifier already in it. So you have to have that on. And another thing that sometimes I've noticed that you'll go into in certain systems. Now, what we're using, I haven't noticed that to be true, but I used to notice that you would go into Audacity. Anyway, make sure that your volume on your microphone right here is halfway. If you do it way to the top, it's going to come in distorted. But other than that, it's just a matter of clicking on the red button and talk. The control buttons up here are the ones that you will use for the most part. They are very simple. Pause, and when you point to them, you notice it says what it is: play, stop, skip to start, skip to end, and record. Okay, now let's play it. This is something I recorded earlier. Okay, wasn't that nice? Okay, so what I'm going to do here is just show you some simple editing things. And okay, if you want to delete something, like one thing that makes this so great to use is you can do really clean edits because you see where the sound waves are. You see, when it's a straight line, that means there's silence there. See? So I'm going to just cut off some of the silence at the beginning and the end. And look, all I did was drug my mouse over it to highlight it, and I'm pressing the delete key. That's all there is. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing: highlight, press the delete key. Easy. Okay, and all that did was trim it up a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to highlight this and let's go look at some of the filters. We're just going to look at a few effects. And oh, I love it that you can like change the speed. I went to effect, change speed, and I'm just going to move this little dial and we'll preview it. I'm not going to save it. Listen. Okay, that was a preview. Well, actually, I'll click OK and I'm going to undo then. Okay, watch what it does. Okay, kind of shrunk it down. I made it faster, so it takes less time. Okay, so that's how we get the elephant and the chipmunk thing. It's one way to do it. Okay, edit, undo, change speed. Okay, now let's come up here and let's make the pitch, change the pitch. And I'm going to click on down and half steps. I'm highlighting that, and I'm going to put in 7 half steps. So let's see what that does. Okay, now listen. Okay, now that was interesting because what that did, let me see. I'm not sure if I did an undo enough of an undo. Okay, so I'm going to undo and undo and undo. Okay, let's see what this plays. Oh, I know what I did. Okay, I was wondering, why does that sound higher? I thought I made it lower. Okay, so I didn't put in a -5, of course. So go to effect, change pitch, okay, and okay, there we go. There's the -5. So a +5 would of course be higher. Okay, now let's listen. Okay, there you go. Now, I wanted to show you this one thing. We're not going to do just a whole lot of different stuff. I'm going to show you how to export before we're done. But let's do the thing where I'm going to. Okay, does this let me. Okay, I am just going to duplicate. See, I'm going to edit and duplicate. Edit. How many do I have here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, that's probably enough. Okay, and then I'm going up to view. Do you see how I'd have to scroll down to see them all? I'm going to view, fit vertically. So I can see all the tracks. You see that? Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to, okay, we'll leave the first one, but I'm going to change the pitch on all the tracks. And that very first instructional video thing that was on posture, you know, I did that, made it sort of sound like aliens at the very beginning. Okay, so this is how I did it. I duplicated the tracks, and now I'm coming up to effects, and I'm going to change the pitch, and okay, we'll have one low like that. Okay. Okay, then we're going to come here to this one. And effect, change pitch. And this one, we're going to go up 3. And this one, the fourth track, let's go up again with that, change pitch. And let's go up 6. That ought to do some interesting stuff. Okay, let's see what it sounds like. Okay, very good. Very, very electronic sounding. It sounds like a robot or something. Okay, so let's save that. Now, okay, here's something I should explain. If you save, well, let's save as well. When you are saving in Audacity, you are saving the project. You are saving the set of instructions. You are not, and it says this right here, saving a project creates a file that only Audacity can open. To save an audio file for other programs, use file export. Okay, so we're going to save the project, and the reason we're going to do that is because you would do this if you want to come in and work on it again later. It saves, it maintains the different audio tracks. You see, right here, there's 4 different tracks, okay? But once you export them, I mean, the best it can do is export 2 tracks for stereo, okay? Or 1 if it's mono. Okay, now my microphone, I don't have it set up as a stereo mic. It's just because of the little group of adapters I have, so everything records mono. But okay, so I'm saving this just if I want to come back in. This is my working copy. Okay, this isn't actually a, you cannot open this file, Audacity Lesson 1 Demo .aup. It's not going to open up in a music player and play. So click save. But now we're going to save it into a file. We're going to go to file export, and notice that there are different formats you can choose. Now we will mostly be using MP3s, okay, but there are WAVs that are the additional the original Microsoft audio format, and AIFF, I don't know how you pronounce that, but that's the Apple format. Aug Vorbis is kind of useful once in a while because that's a Linux format, and it's really, really small, and with a lot of things we are using, it's compatible. So we might use that some. Okay, and then there's all kinds of stuff that I don't even know what it is. So MP3 is what we will use most of the time. So I'm going to click on MP3. Now, when you use MP3 for the first time in Audacity, it does ask you to, a lot of times it will ask you for a certain file, it's called a LAME file. What that is, it's a file that allows you, a little program that allows you to convert it to MP3s, and you have to, you know, like just click OK, and I will include at some point, hopefully, my plan is that this will already be set up for you and your software when you start, but if not, it's a pretty simple thing, and then we'll have a separate instructional video for that. I could show you here, but I've already gone and installed it. So, okay, so here we have. We're going to click on Save, and then it's going to, oh, okay, this already exists. I'm going to click No. Okay, and I'm going to erase demo, because that first file, the file that I started with, was named that. Okay, so I had to choose a different name. There we go. And you can put all this information in here. I mean, I put my name, but you could put the year and genre and comments, et cetera, et cetera. There you go. And I don't know if you knew it before, but MP3 files have all this information. Okay, that's why, if you have a certain MP3 player, and you open an MP3 song, it will show you all this information. Okay, so here we go. Okay, and here it says your tracks will be mixed down to a single mono channel in the exported file. Okay, that's good to know. So it'll only be one track once we mix it down. Okay, and now I'm going to close Audacity. And just to play our song, I'm going to go into Audacious, which is, it's only a player. So I'm going to play file and find my song, which should be down here. Da 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 da. Okay. Okay, so it's not the demo. That was before, but there it is. Audacity Lesson 1. Open. Okay, excellent. Okay, that's the end of this little instructional section, but this is what I want you to do. This is your assignment. Always, I show you how to do things, but then it's going to be your job to go in there and play with it and create your own recordings. And so, your assignment is to, make three or four separate little recordings where you record some audio. And, you know, you could record several tracks of it, and I haven't even talked about how you could put in an instrumental section and sing along with it. We'll get to that later. But anyway, you three or four different recordings, and use the filters to go in and edit your sound and export them to MP3s. Okay, that's it.